I'm Patrick, scored 100 percentile 4 times in CAT. The basic idea about having this particular video is basically to help you understand how to go about preparing for the CAT exam. I somewhere believe a lot of people who are preparing for the CAT exam are preparing it in a very faulty manner. And the idea of this whole session is just to explain you what is the whole process in the way you can ace the CAT. CAT is not very difficult. Problem is the approach is different. And you need to be able to understand the approach if you want to really ace the CAT exam. Okay, I used to prepare for the CAT exam when I was in final year. I couldn't ace it. But then when I learned the approach of how to solve it, is when I started becoming better and better. Okay, and that's what I'm going to share out here. So what I'll do out here is, when I wrote the CAT 17 exam, I wrote in a slot 2. So I will try to go about all the questions of quant in the slot 2 exam and tell you how to approach those questions. And let you know that the approach of these questions are not very difficult, but people have to change the way they look at it, which also means that the way they're studying is a little faulty. Okay, so let's start with the questions that will come in CAT 17 slot 2 and how to approach those questions. So how to score 100 percentile? I mean, you ask me personally, am I very great at quant? I am not. I mean, there are a lot of questions that my students ask me about a quant and I'm not able to answer, but still I'm able to score 100 percentile in the examination. Okay, yes, I did a couple of mistakes, 3 mistakes exactly in the examination, but all the other sums I knew in the exam. I mean, if I just avoided those mistakes, I would have scored out in the examination. So I'll let you know what the mistakes I did and how to go about approaching the questions as far as the exam is concerned. But anyway, to start with, how do you score 100 percentile in the quant? One is you need to really change the approach towards the questions. Now, what has unfortunately happened is the education system spoils us. Now, what is the education system? We have throughout learned how to solve questions by putting equations. So, whenever we get a question, we try to put an equation and try to solve it. We don't try to look at logically how to solve it. So, we put equations, we try to formulate every step and try to get the answer, which is a very wrong approach, which you'll understand. One important thing is you need to unlearn and learn, which I find a lot of students really reluctant to do it. And you have to. I mean, that's one best way to go about really acing that. So you need to unlearn a lot of things that you've learned across the way and learn new things and new approaches of how to go about preparing for the exam. So this is what I'll be covering as and when I solve the sums as such. Second is avoid using equations. So as far as possible, avoid equations and try to solve it logically. So I'll be trying to solve the whole CAT sums. Almost all the sums will be solved without using equations, and I'll tell you how to go about it. Use options wherever possible. It's key for cracking the CAT exam and being fast. If you can be good at options, you can really be fast. And be good at fast and simple mental calculation. I'm not talking about complicated calculation. I'm talking about good at simple mental calculation. Don't go for complicated stuff. And you don't have to mug up tables. You ask me what is 17, 19, I don't know, but I can derive it. 17, 20s are minus 17, 1s, I'll get the answer. Okay, same way, you don't have to know Vedic mathematics and any higher order mathematics. You need to be able to find 10%, 20%, 30%, which is quite simple to go about calculating. If you can do that, you'll be really fast. So avoid using calculators for a simple calculation. Try to use your own mental, this one. CAT doesn't ask you too many complicated calculations. Let's look at the sums and go about it, right? So in this whole video, I'll be only taking 5 sums that have come in the CAT 17 exam. I'll be covering up the remaining questions in the other videos that I'll soon post. So this is the first video of the whole series of videos which will cover CAT 17. So we start with the first question which has come in the exam. Yeah, so this is the first question that has come in the examination. Not a very difficult sum. So if you look at logically, and if you are thinking logically, it's not very difficult. So if you look at it, you cannot use the equation in this. It is just a 3x3 square grid. So if I draw 3x3 square grid, it's just a 3x3 square grid which you need. Right? Now, you have to put numbers 1 to 9. Each number occurs once. Each column, each row, each of the two diagonals add up to the same value. So that means every row and every column and every diagonal add up to same value. So this plus this plus this, every column and the diagonal will add up to same value. Okay, the top left and the top right. The top left is 6 and the top right is 2. okay, you want them bottom middle entry. Now I have not come across this sum before the exam, but I understand when I have solved puzzles that the average of 1 to 9 is 5. Okay, average of 1 to 9 is 5. So that means ideally the average of every number out here is 5. That means the total should be 15, 15, 15. Okay. That the maximum number of times the number will be used is a middle number. And ideally it should be the average, which is 5. So if you're good at solving puzzles, this sum will be easy. I mean, because puzzles are there. There are puzzles based on these numbers. So that's why I normally recommend people to solve puzzles. And that is one good way of trying to prepare for your examination. It helps you not only in your DILR section, but helps you in some questions of quant like this. So if it's 5, we know that each diagonal will be 15. So 2, 5, 7, this will be 8, 15. 6, 5, 11, 4, 15. Okay. So the bottom row is 8 plus 4, 12. So this has to be 3, 15. So we get the answer as 3. Now, if you're not very sure about this, you can continue with it. So 8 plus 6, 14 plus 1, 15. 1 plus 6, 9. 1 plus 5, 6. So this will be 9, 15. 6 plus 2, 8, which is 7, 15. If you look at all the conditions, get satisfied out here. And we get 3 at the bottom. So answer will be 3. So what did we use here? Did we use any equations? No. We didn't use any great stuff. We only used the concept saying the average of 9 numbers is 5. And that should be in the middle. And then try to put in the full box. A very logical way of going about solving it. If you try to solve this mathematically or any other way, it would have been really, really tough. So CAT expects you to think logically as far as when you look at the exam. And that's what you need to build when you're solving, practicing and going about it. Don't focus too much on mathematics. Focus on building on your logical abilities of solve. Okay, so let's look at the next sum. Time for distance, not very difficult. Again, sum A, B, and C, each running at uniform speeds get gold, silver, bronze medals. A beats B by 1 kilometer. Basically, it means that when A runs 10 kilometers, B has run 9 kilometers. Okay, beats by B by 1 kilometers. Similarly, B beats C by 1 kilometer. When B runs 10 kilometers, C runs 9 kilometers. That means the ratio of the distance covered by B and C is 10:9. Right? So when he runs 10 kilometer, he'll beat him by 1 kilometer. 1/10. So when B runs 9 kilometers, C will be 900 meters behind. 1/10. Remember 1/10? So when I said when B completed the race 10 kilometers, C is 1/10 behind of B. 1 kilometer behind of B. So when B covers 9 kilometers, C will be 1/10 behind of B, which is 900 meters. Which means when A covers 10 kilometers, C will be 1900 meters behind. So that is the answer. You don't require equations, you don't require anything. You need to be comfortable with ratios. That's one important concept. There are a few concepts which are important if you for CAT. One is ratios, one is averages, which you need to be comfortable with. Third, this is sort of an average sum. If you know allegation, it's very simple to get the answer. There is no question about it. But there is one more concept which I need to cover called the prime numbers, which is very important and which can get you the answers quite fast. Okay? If you look at the allegation method which you need to be comfortable with, you are mixing milk which is 7 out of 9 in the first container bottle. In the second container it is 9 upon 13. Okay? To get 3 upon 4. Technically, when I thought about this later, I solved it by allegation in the examination. But when I thought about it later, you could have easily make out the answer is B option, purely by prime numbers. Why? Because this 13 will not get cancelled off and will come on this side. Let's look at how. Okay, you need to know allegation. Allegation is when two things are mixed to get the third, and then you do allegation. So you subtract 7 upon 9 and 3 upon 4, okay, which you get 36, 1. Okay, same way 9 upon 13 and 3 upon 4, you get 52, 3. Okay, so you are finding a ratio of this. When you are finding a ratio of this, this will get 4. 9 4s are 36 and 4 13s are. So you will get 27:13, which is B option. Right, 13 comes on this side, 9 comes on this side. 90 is 27:30. So you could have made out that there is a 13 out here. There should have been a 13 in the answer. You could directly mark that as B answer. Okay, because 13 comes out. 13 prime numbers, specifically larger prime numbers, is very difficult to cut. You can only cut it if you have a numerator which is a prime number. But then that is not very easy to come across. Okay. No equations, just the concept of allegation, averages, which is important. As I said, averages and ratios are important. And we use the concept of prime number if you really want to solve it fast. This was a little tough sum. I mean, I took a little extra time because somewhere I did a mistake in calculations in my mind. But yes, it is not very difficult to solve, as I said, using options. So if you have the options, you can easily solve it fast using options. In the previous sum also, we use the option. We use the 13 concept in the option to try to get the answer fast. Here also, we can use the options. So if you read it properly, you're traveling a particular distance. You're coming back at a particular distance, but you're traveling 5 kilometers extra. So if this is x, this is x plus 5. Technically, your total distance comes as 2x plus 5. So if it's 2x plus 5, that means ideally it should be ideally 65 or 55. Because 70, if you make 2x plus 5, x will be in points. Okay. For example, from 70, if I remove 5, it becomes 65, x becomes 32.5. Ideally, the answer will not be in 32.5 because look at all the numbers and proper integers. I'm not ruling them out, but I'm trying to substitute a simple number to start with. Okay, 65, 55. Again, if I look at both the numbers, 55, if I remove 5, what is left is 50, then x becomes 25. Okay, whereas here 65, if you remove 5, you get 60, then x becomes 30. Okay, so we start with this because the initial speed is 60 miles per hour. Okay. Later on, the distance increases, then you can use 25 miles per hour. So I'll start with 60 miles per hour. You can start any one of them, it will not take much time to calculate. So I'll start 60 miles per hour. So he's traveled first 30 miles at 60 miles per hour, which will take him half an hour, 30 minutes. Next, when he's coming back, he's traveling half the distance, which is 15 miles at 25 miles per hour. So 15 upon 25 hours, which is 60% of the hour, you should make out it is 36 minutes. 60% of 60. This is, you should be good at calculation, simple calculation. What is left is, remaining 15 miles, he takes 5 miles extra. So he takes 20 miles. 20 miles at 50 miles per hour. So 20 miles at 50 miles per hour is 40%. 40% of 60 is 24 minutes. So total time taken is 60 minutes, which is half an hour extra, satisfies. So answer will be C option. Okay. I wrote x, but I have not formed the equation out here. I wrote x just to explain you the concept. You don't require to use x out here. The key in the exam is to be able to substitute right option and do it fast. And if you are good at calculations, all these calculations can be done in mind. You don't have to do anything on paper. Out of t shirts produced in a factory, 15% are defective. So here you can always start with 100. Okay, let's say 100 shirts are produced. Okay. 15 are defective, 15 gone. In percentage, you can always start with 100. Left is 85 shirts. 25% is sold in domestic market. So 20% of this should be able to good at calculating 20%. So 10% is 8.5. So 20% is 17. So 17 is sold in domestic market. What is left is 68. Okay. So 68% of this one is 8840. Okay, 68% is 8840, so what is 100%? Okay, you can cross multiply and calculate, it just should not take time. For example, if I do 88 divided by 68 is 1, 20 remainder, 204, so you can make out 68 into 3 will be 204. You can make out the answer will be 13, which is 13,000. One more way of looking at it is a last digit calculation. 13,000 into 68%. Gives you 8840. What it basically means that the last digit should be 4, non-zero last digit should be 4. So 8 into what last digit will give you 4? 8 6s will give you 48, can't be the answer. 8 4s will give you 32, can't be the answer. 8 4s will give you 32, can't be the answer. It has to be 8 3s 24, 4 last digit, non-zero digit. So from based on last digit also you can make out the answer will be B option. So I've just taken a few sums out here. Okay. Just to make you understand the importance of trying to use options and understanding simple calculations. There is no point using equations, there is no point complicating things and going about it. A few cross multiplication etc. will help you to go about doing it. So what is important when you're preparing for CAT is try to build approaches. Don't look at equation. Avoid using equation. Try to build simple approaches to solve the sum. That will help you to be faster. CAT is not difficult. A right approach will help you to be much better and faster. We'll also look at the other sums that have come in slot 2 and then try to look at each and every sum and see how to go about solving it logically and fast. I hope this helps. Thank you.